Welcome to Lingua Latina, Chapter 20, Lesson 1. Listen as I read the Latin aloud. Before we get into the passage, though, look up here at vicesimus. Okay, vicesimus means the 20th. You've been, all the chapters, as we've been going along, you notice have been numbered in the ordinal numbers, counting first, second, third, so capitulum primum, capitulum secundum, capitulum tertium, and right now we're on vicesimum, and vicesimus aum is the adjective that means the 20th, and this little period after the number is what Orberg uses for the th that would go after this, the 20th. And here we have a little crib with a baby, and it is called a cunae. It is plural, you can see here, cunae cunarum, and yet it is translated in the singular in English. It's a crib singular. So cunae sunt means the crib is. Okay, listen now. Parentes. Pueri parvuli, qui nondum fari possunt infantes dicuntur. Parvulus infans in cunis cubare solet. Cunae sunt lectulus infantis. Infans multas horas dormit, non solum nocte, sed etiam die. Nam longus somnus infantitam necessarius est quam cibus. Infans neque somno neque cibo carrera potest. Quomodo infans qui fari non potest cibum postulat. Infans qui cibo caret magna voce vagit. Ita parvulus infans cibum postulat. Tum mater accurit atque infantem ad pectus suum apponit. Infans lac matris bibit. Parvulus infans, cui dentes nulli sunt, non pane, sed lacte vivit. Okay, stop there. Read all of lesson 1 until you get to the Roman numeral 2 in Latin, and then come back and let's try to translate. Parentes. Little boys, pueri parvuli, who are not yet able to speak, fari means the same thing as loqui, are called infants. Dicuntur are called, or a little infant, parvulus infans, is accustomed to lie down in a crib. Again, the plural form, but it's translated singularly, in a crib. Cunae sunt, a crib is the little bed of an infant. An infant sleeps for many hours, not only at night, but also during the day. For the long sleep of an infant is as necessary as food. Tam quam, as something else. An infant is neither able to lack sleep nor food. Carrera means to go without, to be lacking, plus the ablative. So an infant can't be without sleep or food. Quomodo infans, how does an infant who is not able, fari, to speak, again notice that is deponent, right, so it looks passive but it's active, how does it demand food? Postulare is the same as poscara, to demand, to call for. An infant who lacks food cries out, vagit, with a loud voice. In this way, a little infant demands food. Then his mother runs up, ac curit, is ad plus curit, and places the baby to her chest. The baby drinks the lac, the milk, neuter, so that's the neuter accusative, the milk of his mother. A little infant, to whom there are no teeth, or who has no teeth, does not live by bread, but by milk. Okay, go ahead and read through that in the Latin, and meet me in the exercises.